the original pregame. A photographer who took pictures of trans swimmer Lia Thomas actually found out that the Today Show edited the pictures she took so that Lia Thomas would appear more feminine. And now that photographer is speaking out. Sandra Bullock and Channing Tatum ended up meeting in the weirdest way outside of Hollywood. And then I'm answering more questions from you for me for Pop Quiz. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. You know what's really crazy? Not only is the information you hear on the news fake sometimes, but now you can't even trust pictures and videos they're showing you. That's how corrupt things have gotten.
I don't know what to believe.
Photojournalist Erica Denhoff was not happy when she noticed that NBC's Today Show photoshopped pictures she took of the controversial trans swimmer Lia Thomas to look softer and smoother on their face to appear more feminine.
Took me like 3 hours to finish the shading on your upper lip. It's probably the best drawing I've ever done.
Erica told the Washington Examiner, it's really important as photojournalists that we transmit authentic photos that have not been altered. Erica said that she was disappointed by the show's choice and said, I pride myself on providing authentic images as a photojournalist. She then said, when I first noticed the airbrushing on the segment referenced, I thought something was honestly wrong with the video. But then I watched it again and thought, wait a minute, this appears to be intentional. Lia's features are softened.
Well, she's a guy, so.
Look at the side-by-side here of Erica's actual photo and how NBC photoshopped it. And now look at the photos that they used in the first 15 seconds of this segment alone.
When Lia Thomas dives into the pool, she could be sealing her place in NCAA history. The standout swimmer from the University of Pennsylvania will compete to become the first Division I openly transgender athlete to be crowned a national champion.
You know what this reminds me of? When CNN played clips of Joe Rogan on their network and altered a video when the real video didn't look that way at all. It's not only what you're hearing that can be problematic on mainstream news, it's what you're seeing. Don't trust anything at face value, sir.
Excuse me, it's ma'am. It is ma'am.
It drives me nuts that influencers will call out skinny culture and say how it isn't reality, but then they don't get upset about this level of distortion.
Hello, friends. I got fevers.
With President Biden warning us about food shortages, I can't guarantee that we will have much food left in America by June, but I can guarantee that you can take a break from the insanity to have the most memorable trip of your life by attending the Young Women's Leadership Summit June 2nd through 4th in Dallas, Texas. Learn more at tpusa.com/YWLS, and for 25% off your tickets, use code POPlitics.
I'm feeling hungry today.
Channing Tatum and Sandra Bullock ended up meeting off set in a really strange way. They're in a new movie together called The Lost City, but the first time they met wasn't for work, it was in the principal's office for their two kids. See what they said on The Late Late Show with James Corden.
When did you first meet Channing?
In the principal's office at our preschool.
Yeah. Why? What happened?
Totally true.
Yeah.
We have two very, very, very strong-willed little girls that, you know, at that young age, we're very much button heads.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. We'd get calls, and I'm like, please let it be Everly.
Please let it be Lila. I would just be like, of all the people to fight with their daughter.
Hang on, you both got called into the principal's office together.
Yeah. Because they just wanted to know, how can we work this out? So do you remember there was like a day that they had an altercation? I said, do I need to call like Channing or Jenna? What do I need to do? And they said, no, we're just going to give them a task, a challenge.
Ooh.
And the challenge was, who can be the nicest to the other one?
I was constantly getting in-school suspension when I was younger, but it was for stupid stuff like talking or chewing gum. Never anything fun or cool. And there definitely weren't any celebrity parents in the principal's office bailing out their kids. If so, I would have wanted to be in the principal's office all the time.
Now, you deal with the consequences.
Next week, POPlitics is going to finally get the makeover she deserves after 2.5 years. Make sure you're following POPlitics on Instagram so you can watch our design progress with the hammers.
And there's no secret to this. Anybody can paint. Anybody can paint. All you need is a dream in your heart, a little practice.
All right, let's dive into Pop Quiz and see what embarrassing questions you have for me this week. Submit questions every week by clicking the link in our bio, and I'll answer them. This is Pop Quiz. Bailey from North Carolina wants to know, can you spell your boyfriend's last name without looking at it? Oh my gosh, you're putting me on the spot. Okay, let me try. V-A-N-D-E-N, capital N-I-U-E, shoot, I think I'm getting confused. Ah! Let me try again. V-A-N-D-E-N. N-I-E-U-W-E-N-H-O-F.
Woohoo! Oh.
Van de Nieuwenhof. Sky from New Jersey wants to know, what are your top documentary recommendations, specifically true crime ones? I've wanted to get into watching them, but I don't know where to start. Also, your amazing watching POPlitics is the highlight of my day. Thank you. All this week, I've been telling CUTEservatives to watch The Dropout on Hulu, Bad Vegan on Netflix, and you can try The Girl from Plainville on Hulu. I haven't watched it yet, so I don't know if that's good or not, but I'm going to be watching it to try it out. An oldie but goodie is Who Took Johnny, which you'll probably have to find on Amazon Prime and rent it, and then Abducted in Plain Sight on Netflix.
Known as the Spectral Victims Unit. These are their stories.
Abby, also from North Carolina, wrote in to ask, can you be an atheist or agnostic and also be conservative? I suppose, however, I would imagine that's probably more rare because conservatives believe that our rights inherently come from God. The left believes rights are from the government. If conservatives believe that we have rights bestowed upon us by God, then how would you as an atheist or agnostic reconcile with that? I guess we'd have to ask them.
I fear God. Mm-hmm. And I fear the FBI. Only two things I'm scared of in life.
Jordan from Utah asked, if you could only live off potatoes or chicken nuggets for the rest of your life, which would you choose and why? This will shock you, but I would say potatoes because there are so many different ways to eat potatoes and that would help it not be as boring if that's all I can eat for the rest of my life.
Not as extra as the extra large fries I'm eating tonight.
The latest episode of The Spillover is out with leftist dropout from TikTok talking about how she left the left and why, plus what we need to do as conservatives to change people's minds on the left. Find that episode on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. Just search for The Spillover or go to the POPlitics YouTube channel to watch it. And then after that, you know, thumbs it up, subscribe, share your stories, leave a 5-star review, all that good stuff. And as much as we love The Spillover, don't forget POPlitics is the OG. So show us some love by tapping the heart button, comment below the craziest thing a leftist has ever said to you, DM this episode to a church friend and tell them the opening clip is their mom, and please hit the save button. We're back tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. Your Monday life hack is, if you have a fever, put a scoop of grated potatoes that look like shredded cheese, okay, like a pile of it, with vinegar on the bottom of your feet with socks over it. Voila, your fever will go away. It's pop culture without the propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. Support POPlitics, the first ever conservative pop culture daily show, by subscribing to our channel, turning on notifications, and of course, hitting the thumbs up. Also, our main home is on Instagram. Seriously, just trust me, that's where the real magic happens. Follow us there at POPlitics.